The first time that I really realized that I was different than other kids is probably more so when I started going to school, like elementary school, because then I could really tell I was around kids every day and like I had something different than they did, and other kids weren't having surgeries, so there was just something different that wasn't normal.
Taylor is one of our patients with cleft lip, nose, palate. People might not realize this, but cleft lip, nose, and palate is the most common surgical birth defect in America. One in 600 babies is born in the cleft. And I think a lot of people don't realize this because on TV they ask you to donate money to Smile Train or Project Smile, so people think it's only in Africa or China or India, but actually it's the most common surgical birth difference in America.
It made me feel kind of scared because I didn't really know what that meant for me.
For children born with a cleft, people always hear cleft lip palate. Lip always involves the nose, and palate always involves the gums and the upper jaw. The palate is the thing in the roof of your mouth, and that helps close your nose when you're talking. So the palate's job is for speech. Because the upper jaw is also clefted or splinted too, there are a lot of dental issues with these kids that really require a pediatric dentist and an orthodontist to be part of the team.
My first surgery was at 6 weeks. And my second surgery was at a year to repair my lip and then to repair my palate. So ever since I was born, basically, I've been having surgery.
Our team is exceptionally lucky to be part of SLUCADE, St. Louis University Center for Advanced Dental Education, SLUCADE. There's very few centers with such a robust dental school. SLUCADE has training programs in the advanced dental degrees.
Children with cleft lip and palate often have some unique needs that other patients don't have, so it's very important that they have a dental home. We also don't want to complicate their already challenging situation with dental caries. We might have to take out teeth or do fillings or things like that, so we'd like to stay on top of their dental care.
Dr. Lynn did a lot of things for me. The biggest one was my jaw surgery, which was in 2016, which is 3 years ago now, which is insane. But he basically had to cut into my upper jaw to correct my underbite.
This is an operation that requires a lot of planning. The teeth have to be set up so that we can know where to move things. So that means both the teeth have to be in good condition. Pediatric dentistry is involved in that.
It's very important for a patient like Taylor to see both dentistry and orthodontics, because from little all up, on up, we want Taylor to have excellent dental health, and that way she's in the best position when it comes time to see the orthodontist to get the treatment necessary and get the teeth into the right position so she has a beautiful smile.
And so when she was ready for it, that's when we did the surgery. And so that means cutting the upper jaw and essentially breaking it off of your skull, because our upper jaws are attached to our skull. So that has to be done very carefully, move forward. In the old days, we would use distractors, which would stretch the bone. The parents had to turn a millimeter a day. Nowadays, we use 3D printed titanium plates to do it in one step, so they don't have this several month process of growing bone. And as you can tell from meeting Taylor and her befores and afters, I mean, she's really blossomed. She when she smiles, you can see her whole mouth. She has a normal conversational smile.
The jaw surgery was my most dramatic surgery by far, because it completely changed the way I talk, the way I look to other people, the way I sleep and eat. It changed everything about how I live my life.
She's doing great in college. She has two jobs. I mean, really, I can't express what a treat it was to see her again, because she quote unquote graduated from the cleft team, and to see her come back and to share what she's done is incredible.